Today I'll present a social theory which has plagued every segment of our society, culture, religion, and education. Its theory of social constructionism, which gives birth to socially constructed reality. Yes, it's everywhere. Apparently, this theory was proposed by sociologists Berger and Lukman in 1966, but its roots are ancient. The theory asserts that all meaning is socially created. Social constructs might be so ingrained that they feel natural, but they are not. Instead, they are an invention of a given society and thus do not accurately reflect reality. Social construction of reality follows heretical imperative rather than the epistemological or methodological approach. Simply speaking, socially constructed realities are apocryphal and have no foundation. In most instances, social constructionism is used to achieve negative or undesirable objectives. Now I will provide 7 examples of social constructionism so that my viewers can easily understand this theory. First example is globe map of the earth. Many of our fellows firmly believe that the globe map of earth they use regularly actually reflects the true geographical reality of various countries. But my dear fellows, this is not true. Let me give you a couple of examples. Europe and North America, as shown in map, are massive compared to their actual size. Africa, Southeast Asia, and Latin America, not so much. Map shows that Greenland is almost equal to Africa, but it's a big lie. Greenland is not the same size as Africa. People are sometimes astonished to learn. The total area of African continent is 30.37 million kilometers square, whereas the area of Greenland is just 2.166 million kilometers square. So, Greenland is approximately 14 times smaller than Africa. Have you seen how map is fooling you? Second example is birth of Jesus. People believe that Jesus was born on 25th of December. They celebrate his birthday every year. But Christmas was also socially constructed. Luke chapter 2 passages 8 to 14 mention that shepherds were looking after their flock by night when an angel appeared to them and conveyed the birth news of Jesus. Can you tell what shepherds were doing with their flock in the cold nights of December in the city of David? Theologians believe that Jesus was born either in late August or first half of September. My next example is sacrifice offered by Prophet Abraham. Jewish people believe that Abraham, peace be upon him, offered his younger son Isaac, peace be upon him, as a sacrifice. Apparently, this claim is backed by Genesis chapter 22 passage 2. However, reading the passages from chapter 12 passage 2 till chapter 18 passage 5 of Genesis will make you realize that Genesis chapter 22 passage 2 contradicts the covenant of God made with Abraham and his wife Hagar, the covenant of circumcision and your only son notion. My next example is the Green Dome, located in the Prophet's Mosque, Medina, Saudi Arabia. Many Muslims see this monument as a symbol of Islam or associate this dome with Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. This is another socially constructed reality. In fact, Green Dome has nothing to do with Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. It was constructed in 1279 CE, that is 678 AH, during the reign of Egyptian Mamluk Sultan Al-Mansur Qalawun. First, it was made with wood. Before green color paint, it had been painted white, blue, and purple. Let's move to the next example. Many Muslim scholars, theologians, and historians believe that there are 6,666 verses in Quran. This is also a nice example of social constructionism. In fact, this common belief about the number of verses in Quran among Muslims is a complete myth. The next instance is our view of race. The dominant view of race today is also a socially constructed reality. This pseudo-biological concept justifies and rationalizes the unequal treatment of people based on their skin color, body shape, or hairstyle. And the last example of social construction I will include here is parliamentary democracy. We have been told that elected individuals represent the public because they are representatives of the people. Just recall, we have learned in statistics that sample should be the representative of population to get accurate statistical inferences. Now just think how a member of parliament who spent millions of dollars in election campaign can represent poor, labor class, farmers, gypsies, homeless people, working class, etc. I am sure you will start to observe many other socially constructed realities you blindly believe. Come out of fake world. Thank you for joining me today.
Dr. Deanna Landry is here representing the International Journal of Management, Economics, Social Sciences, and I'll let him say something.
Well, good morning. It's nice to see all you folks here. And it's my pleasure. Welcome to the conference for me here in sunny Florida. Now, let me just say a couple of things. I know some of you, a lot of you are very interested in publishing. And so I am today kind of wearing several hats. I'm a presenter, of course, for you, for the National DBA Society. But I'm also an editor for the IJMESS. And you see that right in front of us, the International Journal of Management, Economics, and Social Sciences. There's the mission of the IJMESS. The mission of the International Journal is to publish empirical, academic, theoretical, and review research articles that contribute to the practice of management, economics, and social sciences. All empirical methods like qualitative, quantitative, field studies, lab experiments, action research, greatly appreciated. And believe me, as an editor, I have read just about everything. I've been educated a lot in business just being an editor for the journal. A manuscript making strong empirical and theoretical contributions will be given preference. They are looking for good citations, and that's a stickler with me. As in the introduction, I've been an attorney now since 1985 in two states, and I do look for research. That's very, very key.
The day I deliver it for the benefit of the time, we will have all of the information for Dr. Deanna Landry. As a matter of fact, if you want to publish, go to the website. If you have any questions, then you can send us an email at info@dbasociety.org.